Meet Mozzie, the malaria-carrying mosquito. Malaria has history, lots of it. So here we go. 100 million years ago, everyone's favorite reptiles carried the disease. The first recorded human case of malaria was in 2700 BC in China. A century or two later, ancient Egypt was positively awash with it. Pyramid builders were given garlic to try and keep it at bay. The thing is, they quite like garlic. Cleopatra slept under a bed net, and traces have been found in the skeletons of mummies. Some historians say malaria may have had a hand in the fall of the mighty Roman Empire. At its peak, malaria infected every continent except Antarctica. Over the years, it's got under the skin of some big names too, from kings, explorers and popes, to presidents and poets, and even the odd saint. It's a fact. Malaria is one of history's most fearsome killers. Half the world is still at risk. Every year, almost 500,000 people die from the disease. But in the last 100 years, we've really had malaria on the run. Since 2000, we've slashed the number of deaths by 60%, saving nearly 7 million lives. And when a country rids itself of malaria, it takes a giant step in ridding itself of poverty. For every dollar spent on ending the disease, there's a benefit of $36 thanks to fewer kids and adults missing school or work. We know how to end malaria. What we need now are smarter tools and faster investment to beat the disease once and for all. We have the power to consign malaria to the history books. We know what'll happen if we don't. Malaria must die so millions can live.